This is Seshad Raju. Today we will discuss about the 11th chapter of 10th class, that is trigonometry. Basically, trigonometry is a branch of mathematics. It deals with the lengths and angles of a triangle. First, we can draw a triangle. This is right angle triangle. This is A, B, C. You can imagine it is a theta. First we want to find sine theta. Sine theta equals to this one. Sine theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse. This is equals to opposite means opposite side is AB. AB by this opposite for this, and it is adjacent, and it is hypotenuse. AB by AC, it is the sine theta. Next, cos theta. Cos theta equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. This is equals to adjacent is BC by hypotenuse is AC. Next, we want to find tan theta. Tan theta equals to opposite by adjacent. This is equal to opposite is AB. AB by adjacent is BC. Next, cot theta. Cot theta equals to adjacent by opposite. This is equals to adjacent is BC. BC by AB, opposite. Next, cosecant theta. Cosecant theta equals to hypotenuse by opposite. This is equals to hypotenuse is AC. AC by opposite is AB. Next, secant theta. Secant theta equals to hypotenuse by adjacent. This is equals to AC by BC. From this, sin tan theta equals to AB by BC. This is also we can write as AB by AC and or by BC by AC. This AC AC cancel. Then it is equals to AB by BC. This is AB by BC. So it is AB by AC equals to sin theta and BC by AC equals to cos theta. So we can write tan theta equals to sin theta by cos theta. Cot theta equals to, in cot theta we can write as BC by AB. BC by AB we can also write as BC by AC. BC by AC by AB by AC. AB by AC. AC AC cancel, then BC by AB is the result. So BC by AC equals to cos theta and AB by AC is sin theta. Then we can write cot theta equals to cos theta by sin theta. And also sin theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse. Cosecant theta equals to hypotenuse by opposite. So we can write sin theta into cosecant theta. Cosecant theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse into cosecant is hypotenuse by opposite. So hypotenuse hypotenuse cancel, opposite opposite cancel, then it equals to 1. Then we can write sin theta equals to 1. Here result is 1. 1 by cosecant theta equals to 1. Cosecant theta. Then also cos theta is adjacent by hypotenuse and secant theta is hypotenuse by adjacent. So we can cos theta into secant theta equals to cos theta is adjacent by hypotenuse, and secant theta equals to hypotenuse by adjacent. Hypotenuse, hypotenuse cancel, adjacent cancel equals to 1. Then cos theta equals to 1 by secant theta goes to down, that is equals to secant theta. Cos theta equals to 1 by secant theta, sin theta equals to 1 by cosecant theta, and cot theta is cos theta by sin theta, tan theta equals to sin theta by cos theta. Then from this, tan theta equals to sin theta by cos theta, cot theta equals to cos theta by sin theta. Then from this, tan theta into cot theta equals to this sin theta by cos theta is the tan theta, and cot theta is equals to cos theta into cos theta by sin theta. Cos cos cancel, sin sin cancel equals to 1. Then from this, tan theta equals to 1 by cot theta. And we also write as cot theta equals to 1 by tan theta as ourselves. From this, next, sin theta equals to AB by AC. From these equations, on the triangle, we want to find hypotenuse means from Pythagoras theorem. From Pythagoras theorem, we want to find hypotenuse, that is AC square. AC square equals to, this is BC square plus AB square. This is equals to, and we want to find the BC square by AB square. From this we want to put 1, and AC goes to this side. BC by AC whole square plus AB by AC whole square. From this, BC by AC here cos theta. This is BC by AC. From this it is cos theta. Cos theta whole square plus AB by AC is sin theta. Sin theta whole square. That is equal to cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1. From this, cos square theta equals to 1 minus sin square theta goes to that side, minus will come sin square theta. Cos theta equals to root over 1 minus sin square theta. And also sin theta equals to root over 1 minus cos square theta. And from this, similarly, like this only, cosecant square theta minus secant minus cot square theta equals to 1. Then cosecant square theta equals to 1 plus cot square theta. And from this, cosecant theta equals to root over 1 plus cot square theta. And also, cot theta equals to root over 1 plus cosecant square theta. And also from another equation, secant square theta minus tan square theta equals to 1. Since secant square theta equals to 1 plus tan square theta, then secant theta equals to root over 1 plus tan square theta. And from this, tan theta equals to root over 1 plus secant square theta. This is the basics of trigonometry. We take a quadrant. This is a graph. This is 90 degrees. This is 0 degrees. 90, 180, 270. This is 360 degrees. On this side, we take from this, it is 90 minus theta. It is 180. 180 minus theta. This one. This is 270 minus theta. 270 degrees minus theta. 360 degrees minus theta. This is the forms. If we take 90 degrees, it is change. That is sin 90 minus theta equals to cos theta. And cos 90 minus theta equals to sin theta. And this will be cosecant 90 minus theta equals to secant theta. Secant 90 minus theta equals to cosecant theta. And tan 90 minus theta equals to cot theta. Cot 90 minus theta equals to, this is tan theta. These are positive quadrants. And from this, we want to know all students take coffee. This is all means all are positive. Here sine and cosecant are positive. From this T means tan and cot. Tan and cot are positive. Here is cos and secant are positive. We don't know all this. First we want to know, based on 10th class, we want to know 90 degrees minus theta. The first quadrant is enough for 10th class. Here it is the equations. Sin 90 minus theta equals to cos theta. Cos 90 minus theta equals to sin theta. Cosecant 90 minus theta equals to secant theta. Secant 90 minus theta equals to cosecant. And tan 90 minus theta equals to cot. Cot 90 minus theta equals to tan. 90 means change. Change means sin becomes cos. Cos becomes sin. Cosecant becomes secant. Secant becomes cosecant. Tan becomes cot. Cot becomes tan. From this, we also know the you can take a box. This and take sin theta, cos theta, next tan theta, cot theta, cosecant theta, next secant theta. This is a box. For the standard values, we can by heart that is 0 degrees, 30 degrees, 45, 60 degrees, and the last is 90 degrees. First we by heart sign, that is enough for all the boxes. First sign means, sign 0 means 0, sign 30 is 1 by 2, and sign 45 is 1 by root 2, and sign 60 is root 3 by 2, and sign 90 equals to 1. Okay, next from we know that is sin theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse. And cos theta equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. We all know that. From this, cos theta is reverse of the sine. That is 90 degrees sine 90 is cos theta. That is sine 90 minus theta. You know that sine 90 minus theta equals to cos theta. If you put theta in this place of theta, if you put 0, this will become cos 0 degrees. Cos 0. So sin 90 equals to cos 0. This is sin 90 is 1. Next cos 0 is 1. From this. Next cos 90 minus 30. This is cos 90 minus 30 degrees. This is equals to cos 60 degrees. 90 minus 30 equals to cos 60 degrees. So we can take as from these equations, cos 90 minus theta equals to sin theta. Sin theta is sin 30 degrees. Theta is 30. So we can write sin 30 degrees. Sin 30 here is 1 by 2. Sin 30 is 1 by 2. So we can write sin 30 degrees cos 90 minus 60. This one, sin 30 is cos 60. Cos 90 minus 30 means 60 equals to sin 30. 1 by 2. Can take only reverse that, that is enough. Root 3 by 2. 1 by root 2 is common for both of them. 1 by 2 here, 30 means 60 and 0 is 0 for 90 degrees. Then tan equals to, tan we know that tan theta equals to sin theta by cos theta. Sin theta is 0. For sin, for tan 0 equals to sin 0 by cos 0. Sin 0 here is 0, cos 0 is 1. Then 0 by 1 is 0. Only we can divide both of them, sin theta and cos theta. That is next tan 30 degrees. 30 degrees equals to tan 30 equals to sin 30 by cos 30. Sin 30 here is 1 by 2 and cos 30 is root 3 by 2. 2 to cancel, it is 1 by root 3. From this, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2 cancel, that is 1. From this, 2 to cancel, root 3. 1 by 0, this is 1 by 0, it is infinite. Cot theta is reverse of the tan theta. Cot theta equals to 1 by tan theta or cos theta by sin theta. From this, we can reverse this. Cot theta equals to, here 0 means 0 by 1 is there. Any number that is divided by 1, for 0 by 1 is there, then we can write reciprocal of this 1 by 0. This is infinite. Or we can take reverse also. Root 3, 1, 1 by root 3, 0. Next, cosecant. Cosecant theta equals to 1 by sin theta. You all know that. I told already 1 by sin theta. Here sin theta equals to 0. 0 by 1. 1 by 0 means cosecant 0 equals to infinite. 1 by 0. From this, 1 by 2 is there. Reciprocal of 1 by 2 is 2. Next, 1 by root 2 reciprocal is root 2. Root 3 by 2 reciprocal is 2 by root 3. 1 reciprocal is 1. Next, secant theta. Secant theta is the reciprocal of secant theta equals to 1 by cos theta. This is equals to secant theta, we can write 1 by cos theta. Then here 1 is there, 1 by 1. Then reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of root 3 by 2 is 2 by root 3. Or we can take reverse of the cosecant theta. This is reverse, root 2 to infinite. This is the main box which we can by heart from the trigonometry chapter. So, based on that, in a right angle triangle ABC with right angle at B, in which A equals to 24 units, B equals to 25 units, and the angle BAC equals to theta, find cos theta and tan theta. First, we can take a triangle. Right angle triangle. It is right angle at B. So we can take A, C. A, opposite of A is small a. It is a side of A. And opposite of C is small c. And opposite of B is B. You can take this. Next, they given that A equals to 24 units. And B equals to 25 units. Given A equals to 24 units, B equals to 25 units, from Pythagoras theorem, we know that AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. AC square here is 25, 25 whole square equals to AB equals to C, that is C we don't know, C square plus BC square is 24 whole square, 25 whole square, that is 25 5 5 is 25, 5 2 is 10, 12 5 is 10, 2 to the 4 5 that is 625 equals to c square plus 24 into 24 4 4 16 4 to the 8 9 2 4 8 2 to the 4 that is 6 that is 17 that is 576. Next c square equals to 625 minus 576 goes to that side, that becomes minus. And c square equals to 625 by minus 576 and 1 15 15 minus 6 is 9 5 11 11 minus 7 4 49. C equals to root 49. This c equals to 7 units. This 7. From this cos theta equals to, you know that cos theta equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent here from the BAC, that is A. Angle A is theta. From angle theta, adjacent here is C. C by hypotenuse is B. It is equals to 7 by 25. Next to tan theta. Tan theta equals to opposite by adjacent. Opposite of theta equals to A. A by adjacent is C. A here is 24. 24 by C is 7. This is what? Given that if 3 tan A equals to 4, then find sin A and cos A. From this, given 3 tan A equals to 4, then tan A equals to 4 by 3. It is a ratio, 4 by 3. First, we can take a right angle triangle. It is A, B, C. It is the angle. Then tan A equals to, we know that tan A equals to opposite by adjacent. From this, opposite is this one. This is small a and C and B. Small a equals to opposite here is, we can write 4 by 3. Opposite by adjacent. We can write as 4 something. We can multiply with any number, any alphabet, because it is a ratio. So we can multiply 4 into k or 4 into a something. From this, adjacent here is 3. So c equals to 3k. We can find b value on the Pythagoras theorem. You know that ac square equals to ab square plus bc square. Ac square we don't know, that is b square. Then ab equals to 3k. 3k whole square plus bc here is 4k. 4k whole square. Then b square equals to 3k whole square is 9k square plus 4k whole square is 16k square. Then write as 25k square. B square equals to 25k square. B equals to root over 25k square. B equals to root 25 is 5. K square is k. B equals to 5k. From this, sin A equals to, sin A we know that it is opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite here is 4k. 4k by hypotenuse is 5k. K cancel, that is 4 by 5. Sin A over next cos A. Cos A equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent here is 3k and hypotenuse is 5k. K cancel, 3 by k, 3 by 5 is the answer. Sin A and cos A, we find it. This is what. Right angle triangle ABC, right angle at B. If tan A equals to root 3, then find the value of sin A cos C plus cos A sin C. Cos A cos C minus sin A sin C. From this, I forgot to tell you about this one. This is sin A plus B. Sin A plus B equals to sin A cos B plus cos A sin B is the formula. And cos A plus B equals to cos A cos B minus of sin A sin B, and also sin a minus b equals to sin a cos b minus of cos a sin b. Cos a minus b equals to cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. This is the main formula. For this question, they ask the sin a cos c plus cos a sin c. This is equals to sin a plus c. We want to find sin a cos c. That process also it is easy to find sin a plus c. So we can note this formula for easy process. So sin a plus c equals to sin a cos c plus cos a sin c. Next is this one, cos a cos c minus sin a sin b. From this we can write as cos a plus c. From this we can find the cos a plus c and sin a plus c. This is work for sin a cos c plus cos a sin c. Next, from this triangle they given that tan a equals to root 3. We can take a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle A, it is right angle at B, B, C. Then tan A equals to, it is a tan A, tan A equals to root 3. We know that tan theta equals to opposite by adjacent. T is equals to root 3, they given that. Root 3 by 1. By 1 means root 3 only. So opposite is opposite of tan A equals to root 3. It is root 3k. It is your ratio, I already said. It is root 3k and adjacent is k. 1k or k. Now from this, hypotenuse we want to find. Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem. AC square. This is AC square equals to AB square plus BC square. AC square we want to find. This is equals to AB, here is K square. K square plus root 3 K whole square. This is equals to K square plus 3 K square. This is equals to 4 K square. It is AC square. AC equals to root over 4 K square. This is equals to 2 k square is k. AC equals to 2k. This 2k. Then we want to find sin of a plus c. That is sin of a plus c we want to find. Or you want to find something. We don't have angles, so we want to find sin a. First we want to find sin a. Sin a from triangle, this sin a equals to, sin a means opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite here is root 3 k by hypotenuse is 2 k. K k cancel, root 3 by 2. From next, cos a equals to, cos a equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. This is equals to adjacent here is k. K by hypotenuse is 2k. 1 by 2. Next, we want to find c. Sin c equals to sin c we want to find. Sin c equals to, from c opposite is k and hypotenuse is 2k. It is 1 by 2. And cos c equals to, cos c from c is adjacent here is root 3k. Root 3k by hypotenuse is 2k. K k cancel, that is root 3 by 2. This is the values. Next we want to substitute these values in the this question. It is sin a here is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 into into cos c. Cos c equals to root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 plus cos a. Cos a here is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into sin c equals to 1 by 2. You want to find this? Since root 3, root 3, root 3 whole square, that is 3. 3 by 2 to the 4 plus 1 by 2 to the 4. This is equals to LCM 4. 3 plus 1 equals to 4. 4 for cancel 1. First question answer is 1. And next, cos A. Second one. Cos A here is 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into cos C here is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 minus sin A here is root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 into to sin C here is 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Then by multiplying both of them, root 3 by 2 to the 4 minus root 3 by 2 to the 4. This is equals to 0. Second question answer is 0. Is or in the secant squared 60 degrees minus tan squared 60 degrees by sin squared 30 degrees plus cos squared 30 degrees. I already explained this one. Secant 60 equals to this solution. Secant 60 we know that 2 whole square minus tan square tan 30 equals to root 3, root 3 whole square by sin 30 equals to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 whole square plus cos 30 equals to root 3 by 2 whole square. This is equals to 4, 4 minus 3, root 3 whole square is 3, 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4. This is equals to 1 by 4 is LCM. Then 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 for cancel, that is 1. 1 is the answer for this question. Next we want to find the right angle triangle PQR. Right angle is at Q and PQ equals to 6 cm. R angle RPQ equals to 60 degrees. Determine the length of QR and PR. First we want to draw the right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. This is a right angle at Q. Then PR, PQR, then RPQ, it is the angle 60 degrees. P angle is 60 degrees. Then PQ equals to 6 centimeters. They're given PQ equals to 6 centimeters. Angle P equals to 60 degrees. On this, we want to find the first, we want to find any one of these. Hypotenuse or opposite. First we want to find hypotenuse, then cos. We know adjacent of this, so we calculate cos theta. Cos theta equals to adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent by hypotenuse equals to adjacent here is 6. 6 by hypotenuse we don't know. Cos 60 equals to cos 60 only, no, is on P. Angle P is 60 degrees. Cos 60 equals to 6 by hypotenuse. Cos 60 equals to 1 by 2. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. 6 by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse equals to a cross multiplication. 6 to the 12. 12 centimeters. Hypotenuse is 12 centimeters. From this, or we can do Pythagoras theorem, or also we can do opposite by hypotenuse from this sin theta or Pythagoras theorem. As usual, we can take any of this. Sin theta equals to opposite by hypotenuse. This is opposite is QR, we don't know that. Hypotenuse is 12. Sin 60. Sin 60 degrees equals to QR by 12. Sin 60 equals to root 3 by 2 equals to QR by 12. Then QR equals to by cross multiplication 12 root 3 by 2. 2 1s to 6. then QR equals to 6 root 3. This is the answer. They want to find QR and PR. QR is 6 root 3 and PR is 12 centimeters. Then go. If A comma B comma C are interior angles of a triangle ABC, show that tan A plus B by 2 equals to cos C by 2. We know that interior angles means the sum of the interior angles of a triangle, sum of interior angles of triangle equals to 180 degrees. You know that. So first we can take angles. This is a triangle A, B, C. So we can take angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 degrees. Then A plus B equals to, we want to find tan A plus B by 2, C equals to the side, cos C by 2. So we can make this C to go that side, 180 degrees minus C. We want to find by 2, so we want to divide both the from left side and right side with, divide with 2, A plus B by 2, 180 degrees minus 2 minus C by 2. This is A plus B by 2 equals to 180 by 2, this is equals to 90 degrees minus C by 2. Now we want to find tan on the both side. Multiplying tan on both sides, then tan A plus B by 2 equals to tan of 90 degrees minus C by 2. Now tan A plus B by 2 equals to tan 90 minus theta, that is tan 90 minus theta equals to cot theta. Here tan 90 minus C by 2 here, so this is theta, so we can write cot C by 2. This cot C by 2 is the answer. Oh, given like this, 1 plus tan theta plus secant theta into 1 plus cos theta, 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta, find this one. Then first we want to multiply both this equation, both these forms. So first we want to multiply with 1 into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta plus, next we want to multiply with tan theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta, next secant theta into 1 plus cot theta minus cosecant theta. On this, 1 into 1 same only, cosecant theta plus tan theta into 1, that is tan theta plus tan theta into cot theta. You know that tan theta equals to 1 by cot theta. From this tan theta here 1 by cot theta into cot theta, that is 1. Okay, tan theta is sin theta by cos theta, and cot theta equals cos theta by sin theta. They both are cancelled, so becomes 1 minus tan theta into cosecant theta plus secant theta into 1 secant theta plus secant theta into cot theta minus of secant theta equals to 1 by cosecant theta. We know that secant theta means this hypotenuse by adjacent, and cosecant theta is hypotenuse by opposite. So this can write secant theta equals to 1 by cos theta. Secant theta equals to, okay, secant theta into cosecant theta, we multiply both of them. And from this, one how many ones are there? Two ones are there. 2 plus cot theta, here cot theta is there, minus cosecant theta. Next, you can write all that. Cosecant theta plus tan theta plus secant theta. You can write minus of tan theta. Tan theta is sin theta by cos theta. Cosecant theta equals to 1 by sin theta. Sin theta cancel. Next, plus secant theta plus secant theta equals to, can write as 1 by cos theta into cot theta equals to cos theta by sin theta. Cos theta cancel. Next, minus of secant theta. Secant theta is 1 by cos theta. Next, cosecant theta is 1 by sin theta. So, next one. 2 plus, can write cot as cos theta by sin theta minus of cosecant as 1 by sin theta plus tan theta as sin theta by cos theta plus secant theta by 1 by cos theta minus of 1 by cos theta. Here also 1 by cos theta plus secant theta is 1 by cos theta. Next plus 1 by sin theta minus of 1 by cosecant and cos theta into sin theta. So next 1 by sin theta minus 1 by sin theta plus 1 by sin theta cancel. Plus 1 by cos theta minus 1 by cos theta cancel. Next the sin theta sin theta cos next 2 plus here there are cos theta by sin theta plus here sin theta by cos theta minus of next plus 1 by cos theta minus of 1 by cos theta into sin theta. We can take LCM for this. It is cos theta into sin theta is the LCM. Sin theta is there. Next cos theta. Cos theta into cos theta. That is cos squared theta. Plus cos theta is there. So sin theta into sin theta. Sin squared theta. Plus cos theta is there. Sin theta. Minus of cos theta sin theta. Both of them are there. So minus 1 is there. This cos squared theta plus sin squared theta is 1. 1 minus of 1. Next, we can do this, someone for tan theta plus minus tan theta. Sorry, you can take secant theta 2 times, so sorry, please, cos theta you just cancel, sorry, this will also cancel. Next, cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. 1 minus of 1 by cos theta into sin theta. 2 is there. 1 minus 1, 0. Then 2 plus 0 equals to 2 is the answer. So that root over 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a equals to secant a plus tan a. First, they are given that. Given that root over 1 plus sin a by 1 minus sin a. Can multiply numerator and denominator with root over 1 plus sin a. It is 1 plus sin a by 1 plus sin a on both numerator and denominator. Then it will become root over 1 plus sin a whole square. Then denominator is t is in the form of a plus b into a minus b. It is equals to a square minus b square. So we can write 1 plus sin 1 minus sin a into 1 minus 1 plus sin a is equals to 1 square minus sin square a. Now we know that cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1. Then cos square theta equals to 1 minus of sin square theta. This is cos square a. If theta equals to a, then cos square a equals to 1 minus sin square a. So 1 minus sin square a equals to cos square a. On this, 1 plus sin a whole square by it is cos square a. Square square cancel. Square whole square you can write. Sorry. Concept. You can write as root over 1 plus sin a by cos a whole square. Square root cancel. Then it will become 1 plus sin a by cos a. Can divide both of them with 1 by cos a plus sin a by cos a. 1 by cos a is secant a plus sin a by cos a is tan a. And the answer is over. Cosecant theta plus cot theta equals to k. They given that. Then prove that cos theta equals to k square minus 1 by k square plus 1. Then given cos theta cosecant, sorry, cosecant theta plus cot theta equals to k. From this we want to square both of on both sides, left and right. Cosecant theta plus cot theta whole square, squaring on both sides. Then k square equals to cosecant square theta on the basis of a plus b whole square. Cosecant square theta plus cot square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. Then you know that cosecant square theta minus cot square theta equals to 1. Then cosecant square theta equals to 1 plus cot square theta. From this, k square equals to cosecant square theta we can write as 1 plus cot square theta. Cosecant square theta we can write as 1 plus cot square theta plus cot square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. Next we can write 1 plus 2 cot square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. K square. 1 goes to this side. K square minus 1 equals to 2 cot square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. This is the first equation. Then from this given cosecant square cosecant theta plus cot theta equals to 1. Same as like this first equation, squaring on both sides, k square equals to cosecant square theta plus cot square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. Yes. In the first equation we substitute this cosecant square theta by 1 plus cot square theta. The second equation we want to substitute the cot square theta. We want to find the cot square theta from this equation. Cosecant square theta minus cot square theta equals to 1. Then cot square theta equals to this one. Cosecant square theta goes to this side. Then it will become cosecant square theta minus of 1. If cos square theta goes to this side, plus will become. Then cos square theta equals to 1 goes to this side. Then minus 1 becomes. Then it is equals to cosecant square theta minus 1. Cos square theta equals to cosecant square theta minus 1. Then k square equals to cosecant square theta as it is we can write. Cos square theta we can write as cosecant square theta minus 1 plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. Minus 1 goes to this side, then it will become k square plus 1 equals to cosecants are there, 2 cosecants are there, so 2 cosecant square theta plus 2 cosecant theta into cot theta. It is the second equation. We want to find the k square minus 1 by k square plus 1. From this 1 and 2, 1 by 2 equals to first equation divided by second equation. Then k square minus 1 by k square plus 1 equals to here 2 common, 2 of cot square, cot is also common. You can take cot also common. 2 cot theta is common. Then cot theta is there. Cot theta plus here cosecant theta is there. This is cosecant theta. And from the second equation, want to find the 2 cosecant theta common. 2 cosecant theta common. Then cosecant theta plus cot theta is there. Then cosecant theta plus cot theta are cancelled. Both are cancelled. 2 2 cancel. Then cot theta we can write as, cot theta we can write as cos theta by sin theta. We can write cot theta. Next, cosecant theta we can write as 1 by sin theta. Cosecant theta we can write as 1 by sin theta. Cot theta we can write as cos theta by sin theta. Sin theta cancel. Then it is cos theta. It is the LHS. So cos theta equals to k square minus 1 by k square plus 1 equals to cos theta. It is 11th chapter of 10th class, that is trigonometry. If you have any doubts regarding to this chapter, comment in the comment box. If you like my video, please like and subscribe it. Thank you so much.